good day, student at home. We are going to continue from where we stopped yesterday. Don't forget that yesterday we looked at the General Assembly, and I did tell you that today we'll be looking at the Security Council. Now, under the Security Council, we have two lesson objectives. The first one, we are to describe the internal structure of this council. And the next one, we are to look at the powers and the functions of this Security Council. Now, the first thing we need to know about the structure, the internal structure of this council, is that it is the most powerful organ of United Nations. It decides everything in this international organization. It has 15 member states, 10 non-permanent, and 5 permanent members. Yesterday, I told you that I'm going to explain the meaning of non-permanent members. They are not permanent in this organ. We only have 5 permanent members. They are the USA, Britain, Russia, China, and France. They are permanent. But the 10 will be elected by the General Assembly. Now, each permanent member has a veto power. Let me quickly explain the meaning of veto power. It shows that every decision taken in this organization must be agreed by the 5 permanent members. If one would disagree, then the decision will not be taken. You will see that when we get to advantage of the achievement of United Nations, you see that this alone will lead us to look at the disadvantages of this veto power, because most powerful countries use this veto power to their own benefits. Let's quickly look at the functions and the powers of this Security Council. Number one, it is charged with the responsibility of preventing wars, that is major wars. Don't forget that we look at the League of Nations. The League of Nations was established in 1919. And the main purpose of the League of Nations was to prevent another major war. But it failed because in 1939, another war broke out. That was the Second World War. By the time the war ended in 1945, nations of the world began to look at another way of preventing a major war. And this council was charged with this responsibility. You will agree with me that ever since 1945, there had not been any major war. The second function of this council is that it appeals to countries to settle their grievances peacefully. This council preaches peace, that instead of countries to go to war, they should settle their grievances peacefully. And the last but not the least, the council recommends the suspension of any member, any country that will not actually support peace. The major aim of this international organization is to promote peace and to protect fundamental human rights. If any country will abuse the fundamental human rights of its citizen, this council will recommend its suspension. I will also be sending some materials for you to understand this topic better. Thank you very much. Bye for now.